Alright, and hey there, Proxians, and this is ProxFight here, and guys, and welcome back to another episode of the Kirby and the Forgotten Land Let's Play. So if you guys missed out during the last episode, we actually went and conquered it with another one of the missions that was over at the desert section that we were at, and now it seems like I believe we got ourselves now, well, almost, I think, getting close to where the boss is by at this point, because I think we got ourselves, I think, one more mission left, and or I think we got ourselves the boss. I'm not really too entirely certain on how we're supposed to be seeing how that episode is going to be playing out here for today. But if you guys can go probably see, we got ourselves a brand new unlockable little place. Now I did this literally right off recording when I was actually going and starting off with this episode, and it seems like we got ourselves, since we actually do have 155 wallets, we can now literally go and do a little bit of some fishing here, which that seems pretty interesting. So I guess we got ourselves flash fishes. So when the fish bites, we can press on the button icons that will appear and press the correct buttons as fast as you can and don't let them get away. So I wonder if you can actually be able to get like star coins or something like every so often, so that we can actually be able to go and grind out for star coins. I think that would be pretty cool. So keep on catching. So if you catch several fish in a row, you'll eventually snag a big one. Huh, alright. Well, let's go try this out. We'll become a Fisherman Kirby here. Oh, no, hold on. Hold on, I got the wrong one. Ah, ouch. Okay, I pressed on the wrong button there. Hold on, let's go and try this out again, and we'll make sure. All right, so what are we gonna do? X. All right, there we go, and we got ourselves a fish. Oh, it's a little baby's guy. But there we go. So yeah, it seems like that is gonna be kind of like the way of how we're gonna be able to get ourselves some extra more money that way. So that'd be pretty cool. But I think if you keep on, so it seems like if we keep on doing it a consecutive amount of times, we'll be able to grab much bigger fishes, and then we'll be able to get more bigger coins along the way. So very cool indeed. All right, now I know that I was going to try and basically do all these little dimension type of things on my, well, I think I may probably take care of these on my own time. I don't think I'm going to go and literally showcase off like every single type of little star dimension that we actually have to go through, because I think that you guys already kind of get the gist of like how those mini games kind of work at this point. But yeah, I believe we actually do only have literally one more mission that we do have to go through, and that is going to be Moonlight Canyon. Now, I know that we got ourselves just the boss literally right up ahead here, so we'll kind of have to hold out on the boss until later. But let's go and try out Moonlight Canyon. We'll go and jump into this, and we'll continue onwards with the actual story that is going to be happening as well too. And this place actually looks really nice. This actually seems like it's going to be one of my favorite areas here for this one particular, well, for the whole desert section. So we kind of have to go and do a little bit of some drilling around in here as well too. So I wonder if we can actually get ourselves anything special around in here. I guess nothing. Alright, so nothing too entirely special with our drilling function right now at the moment. So we'll just have to be a little bit careful while we go and do any type of drilling around, because it seems like those blocks are going to break and that's not going to be good. But there we go, got ourselves our very first castle for this episode. Very nice. Let's make sure that we get this guy out of the way as well too, so that he doesn't have to become a too much of a problem. Oh, and I think we may probably get something good here. Yep, got ourselves the twin drill blueprint. Wow, we're just getting all the different blueprints right now, aren't we? Very cool. And I think we do have one of these posters here, so seems like we have to go and take care of some more wanted posters. So that is one out of three, so we'll just have to keep a lookout for those. I know that we've been seeing those guys quite often throughout in some of the other different past sections. Oh no, we got ourselves another light up room type of area that we have to go and walk into with. I can see that this is going to become a big problem, so we're going to make sure that we're going to basically use our little function here to kind of help us out a little bit. Alright, so let's go and light up on this guy here, and we'll just keep on pressing down like so. Alright, and now it's onwards to the next part. So this seems like this is like some sort of like abandoned mine! Whoa, yeah, could not see all the way through there, that was a little bit dark. So we'll just have to make sure that when we go through any of the big dark areas that we have to be super careful. Now, I don't think I could probably go and jump across to that, can I? No. Okay, so unfortunately I cannot do that. I think we have to go around a whole other different way to go and do that here. Okay, so there's also this guy. Oh no. Okay, that could become a problem. Oh no. Okay, we have to go all the way around this side. All right, perfect. And I think we're almost there. Oh, hey, I do see that there's some milk in a bottle there. I should probably be able to go and pick that up soon, hopefully. Okay, just go. Yep. Okay, there we go. We made it, and we also got some extra food in the process. Oh, thank goodness. And, oh no, we got some cannons to mess around as well. This could be a problem. Ouch. I wasn't fully prepared for that one. Okay, Let's keep on moving down this way. Oh, these guys are going to break on their own instead of us using the drill this time. Okay, so we have to go and head through this side to actually reach on over to this pathway. Now, I hope you guys do go and check out on the Pokemon Shield randomizer that is also going to be happening, because we are actually going to be going and continuing our way on over to where I believe where Route 9 is going to be, and that is where we're going to be heading on over to. Okay, let's just keep on holding it down on the B button there. Okay, with that being said, we now got ourselves the ramp, and we also got ourselves a Waddle Dee to be rescued. Oh, wow, and that's the second one so far, so we already missed out on the first one, so I would have no idea where that would actually be located at. But here's also another poster, so we may probably need to go spit this out for the time being. There we go. So now we got ourselves another wanted poster already removed, so perfect for that. And off we go, back inside, we go into more of this darkened section around here. Oh, wow, I guess we don't really need this anymore now. So as always, back to the outside, and thank goodness that we're out of that darkness area for the time being. But let me guess, we need to go and probably use up the cutter function here for the time being as well too. Just so that we can see what is happening around here. Alright, so we go. Oh no, we got these guys. We got these random wannabe boo guys that just want to go and try to attack us, but if I kind of look away, they're going to hide. Okay. Be careful. Oh no. Just go. Just head over here. Rescue out the Waddle Dee. Perfect. Okay. Let's get the heck on out of this little spot, because it's going to be like Mario Sunshine here, where all these little blocks are going to like start to fall over. Now, I think there was another water poster right there. So there we go. Got all the Waddle Dees for that. Or well, not all the Waddle Dees, but all the posters to get that Waddle Dee. All right. Now we have to head up over here now. Well, hold on. Maybe there could be something else that could be down below this way. Ah, okay. Now, I think we may probably have to go and probably take a little bit of a detour, because I think normally sometimes on detours like this, we can always be able to get some extra new things around here. And I think I do see that there looks to be like a secret. Okay, super careful with this. Just watch out for the Gyarados, and we should be able to go to the secret exit. All right, there we go. Perfect. Alright, so secret entrance from here, and oh no, this seems like a problem in itself, because if we don't do this on proper timing here, okay, nice. Alright, so we got ourselves another capsule. Now these things are going to break as quickly as they can, and that's not going to be fun. Alright, go, 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 and do that as quickly as you can there, Kirby. Oh jeez, nope, not today, dude. Oh, we could actually become Sleeping Kirby. No, I didn't want to have that for it to happen. Ah, no. Ah, the Sleeping Kirby got me. No, I didn't want to have to go and fall asleep from there. Now I just lost my cutter ability. So that was the whole problem right there. Is that if we actually went and hit with that Sleeping Kirby, we would be too dazed to actually just go and try to grab it on that Waddle Dee there. But hopefully I can at least find another cutter ability somewhere around this place, then I can be, hopefully at least be able to do it. Okay. There we go. Flying out the Sleeping Kirby there. And head all the way up into this little spot. And anything special around here? I don't think so. I think there's just only just another entrance way to just keep on falling through. And what do we got? Anything? Can I just go and do a little bit of a sliding tackle or something? Nope, I can't even go and break that down right now. Oh, we're gonna go back into Flying Kirby again. Very cool. So let's go and try this out. Now we just have to just be very careful on our toes to spot out exactly on what is gonna happen around in here. All right, just keep on being careful. Just land on any of these things that we can see around here. All right, nice. Okay, I don't see a Waddle Dee yet, but it may probably be happening soon. And just watch out for these guys there. Nice, take them out. Go through this one and go right through the red one. Sweet. And oh no, just go through it. Perfect. Oh god, more falling beams. Oh no, they're coming from the other side too. What? Nope. Okay, now this may probably be a little bit of a tricky one. Because I know that there's going to be a hidden Waddle Dee somewhere around here that I have to go and like literally spot out from. Here we go. And just like that, we got ourselves the Waddle Dee. Perfect. Okay, didn't know exactly when there was going to be a fork in the road or whatnot, but we got it now. Alright, so now we don't have to worry about having to go and retry it anymore, because I think they will probably give us a retry here if we needed it. But, yeah, we're good. We don't need it now. Ugh. But I don't know how I'm going to be able to... Oh, there we go. Sweet. We don't need to worry about breaking anything. We got it right here. Anything hidden behind this section? No. So nothing hidden behind there. So the only thing that we just have to go and worry about now is let's go grab ourselves the chill ability. But either way, we'll just go and make sure that we grab out all these other Waddles that need to be rescued. Oh, sweet. Okay, now unfortunately this is not going to be 100% though, but at least we got enough Waddles in our arsenal to kind of help us out a little bit more with our collecting. Alright, so we got ourselves Shotzo, which I don't think I ever really knew about those guys' names. And we got ourselves the Knock Knock Nut. Now, we've been seeing those for a little bit. I know that there was actually one part, there was actually a Waddle Dee mission that we actually had to go and do for one of those Knock Knock Nuts there. But with that being said in mind, though, we can now finally get this section that is over here where the boss area is going to be. And that can now finally be opened to our advantage now with the 25 Waddle Dees that we do have within this whole entire area. Alright, so go and smash that on down. And with that being said, we got the Collector in the Sleepless Valley. So we would have to hold this episode off until the next one. So the Waddle Dees helps you out, open up the gate that was blocking the way, head to the stage and challenge the boss that's guarding the territory. And of course, we always go ahead and do that. And another little dimensional, well actually two dimensional little sections are now finally open to us. But I'm going to go and end it off here. I'm going to take care of these guys on my own time. I don't think you guys really need to go and see me having to worry about having to go through all these little rare stone missions. But I'll take them on my own time. But we'll go and hop into the next section, which that is going to be the boss that is going to be over here, the Collector in the Sleepless Valley. We'll be taking care of that within the next one. So I'll be seeing you guys then, and peace.